wonder.
Should I leave this earth today, I would feel content.
Diana Ross.
Gordy didn't particularly want to release every jot and touch.
Curtis Mayfield.
Don't you think maybe I deserve a few years off?
Peaches and her.
People want to meet us because their emotions are at
a peak. The Temptation.
We like to think of ourselves as the trends.
Evelyn Champagne King.
We want to hear you. We want to see
Richard
you.
Richard Pryor.
What you want, man?
Ray Charles. Tom Summer. Ella Fitzgerald. Jerry Butler. The Stylistics. Roberta Flack. Marvin Gaye. Smokey Robinson. Michelob presents Special Edition. Special Edition. An inside look at the fascinating lives of America's top entertainers. Hi, I'm Sid McCoy, and this hour we feature an intriguing young woman whose innocent appearance and casual manner belie the fact that she is a serious triple threat in the music business. As a writer, a producer, and of course, as a performer. Teena Marie, the dynamic young lady from Los Angeles, a rising star who is as spiritual as she is spirited. We'll hear how the talented Lady T got her start in show business and how every step in her career is a new challenge when Special Edition continues. With Teena Marie, every record is different. That's what makes her so exciting. But when it comes to beer, you don't want any surprises. And you know a Michelob will always be smooth and mellow. And that's exciting, too.
Weekends can happen anytime. Weekend, no
week. Yeah.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri. They said it couldn't be done, but Teena Marie keeps right on doing it. As a producer, she's a woman in a man's world, and she's one of the few white artists whose records go straight to the top of the soul charts. We'll learn how Teena Marie reacts to these seeming contradictions in her life, right after this. On April 6, 1979, the Motown label released the first single by an artist who had been signed to the company nearly 4 years before. But the long wait, that painful period of learning the ropes and the road, of paying your dues, was surely justified when the record went on the charts and climbed right up to the top 10. An unknown singer named Teena Marie had herself her very first hit.
Well, I read you freaks.
Today, with 4 albums to her credit, the name Teena Marie is virtually synonymous with the soul charts, an evolution that Lady T takes almost for granted. After more than 2 years, she is just beginning to break into the pop market, the very market in which one might have expected her to begin her career.
Well, my records have always gone black first before anything else. This is my first, like, pop, you know, first record that really crossed over. Behind the Groove did pretty, you know, pretty well, but not as big as this, you know. Sucker for Love was like a basically, you know, R&B song, you know. So it put me there. Plus, that's a place that I've liked to be, and it's a place that I came from, and it's a place that I'm going to continue to be at.
At least, at the beginning, Teena Marie got to the place she's at with a bit of help. That was Rick James, the Prince of Funk himself, who was sharing the lead vocals with Lady T on I'm a Sucker for Your Love. And it was Rick who wrote most of the songs and produced the album as well. Now, Wild and Peaceful was their first and last formal collaboration. But Teena Marie still gets around to singing on Rick's own sessions. There is absolutely no doubt that Teena Marie is an extraordinary singer. We'll find out how she started writing and then producing, too, when Special Edition continues.
So go ahead and pour that smooth and mellow beer.
It's Michelob.
All week long, the spirit belongs.
Put a little weekend in your week.
Don't you wait to have a Michelob.
Make it special, weekdays too.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri. We'll be back with Special Edition right after this. By the time she was 13, Teena Marie was singing with her own band. And by the time she finished high school, she was an accomplished musician, playing both guitar and piano. She didn't really begin to develop her talent as a songwriter, however, until after she started recording.
I only wrote one song on that first album, and it was I'm Gonna Have My Cake and Eat It Too, which is very significant, also symbolic. I remember doing that song and saying to myself, since I'm only gonna have one song on this album, it's gonna be that one, because this is not where I stop. Anyone can do somebody else's song, but it's challenging to like write your own, you know. Luckily, I've written for like a long time. I never really thought I was a great songwriter until like maybe 3 years ago. I think like one of my best songs that I've ever written was on like the second album called Aladdin's Lamp. The song is like takes you into three different spaces of different feelings of music, you know. And it goes from almost like a Louisiana riverboat feel into like Earth, Wind & Fire into like straight out blues, you know. And like I remember somebody telling me that, wow, you know, you could like write three different songs, you know, from this one song. Why don't you like take it apart and like, you know? And I said, because that's like not the purpose. This song has another purpose. Whether or not it goes to number one pop means nothing to me, you know. What means something to me is that it's like a great serious feeling that came straight from my heart, and that I conveyed it exactly the way that I wanted to convey it.
We were rich and we were.
We'll hear more from that second album entitled Lady T when Special Edition continues.
Weekends can happen anytime.
Weekends are just a frame of mind.
So go ahead and pour that smooth and mellow.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri. I'm Sid McCoy, and Teena Marie talks about the singers who've influenced her and about her own influence as a producer right after this.